joining me today for lunch. Hope you're enjoying lunch that I provided for you. The reason why we're here today is because some of you may know I am a candidate in the Metro Lisa Ivy program, where I am doing my certification for educational leadership. As a part of the program, I am conducting two research. One is a short term, one is a long term. So today we're just doing the short term. And we are going to be discussing building capacity for bookkeepers. You know that we have had or are still having challenges with our bookkeepers, so we're here today to kind of throw some stuff out there, talk about what we're currently seeing, the reason why we're seeing it, and what can we do to going forward to fix or solve the mystery of what's going on with our bookkeepers. So it's going to be very interactive, so please feel free to jump in. There are sections in the presentation where we're going to be opening for discussion and feedback, so be yourselves. Can we? All right. Secretaries, you have worked with bookkeepers for a long time, and you have been seeing having challenges with our bookkeepers in getting your work done, and getting requisitions turned in accurately for the first time, the second time, maybe the third time. But we've been having several challenges. As a result, funding are not spent timely. Requisitions are not being processed in a timely manner so we can get the resources to the students in an appropriate time where they can use to help them achieve their goals in school. So today's purpose for the presentation is we're going to discuss and identify the root causes of the bookkeeper's competence to effectively and efficiently perform their duties and responsibilities as Title I bookkeepers. Okay? So, we brought a group together. It's about five of us came together and developed some survey questions to send out to the bookkeepers to kind of get temperature check as to the bookkeepers, where they are, and how they became a bookkeeper, their qualifications, their background. So here are some of the questions that the team put together. How many years have you been in your current position as a bookkeeper? Prior to becoming a bookkeeper, what was your position? What is your current Excel level? Because you know we do the budget logs and Excel spreadsheets. And in what areas do you have experience in? So we list a couple of financial areas that they would need to help them do their job. And how many years were you in your previous position? What financial system have you used in the past? Because we want to know, do you have the skills, the background necessary to be a bookkeeper? And here are some more questions. What support do you provide to your school on a daily basis? They could be tied up doing a lot of things which prevent them from doing their bookkeeping responsibilities. What interpersonal skills do they possess to assist them in this position as a bookkeeper? List any prior training that they've had, and what do you want the district to train you in to make you a better bookkeeper? So we're asking them, tell us what you want us to train you on. So here are the results. As you can see, the 3 to 6 years has sorry. Can you do that?
No. Is 3.5?
The green.
Oh, 35. It's either 35 or 3.5.
It's 35. So we only had 57 bookkeepers that responded to the survey. And of the 57, we have 3 to 6 years if they're in their current position as a bookkeeper, between 0 to 6, the most, because I think it's 36%. Okay. And as you can see, we have a large amount of individuals 10 years or above as a bookkeeper. So you're thinking, if you are a bookkeeper for 10 or more years, come on now, we should not be having the quality of work, or lack thereof, coming over to us. Because you've been in this role for a while. Even 3 years, you're supposed to have this done back. And in the light that we have trainings every year, and different kinds of training. All right, so prior to becoming a bookkeeper, what was your position? So the first column there is a secretary. So they worked as a secretary for just over 40% of them worked as secretaries. Bookkeepers, you can see, is less than 30%. About 25% or so were bookkeepers before. And here we go, over here, we have almost 60% other. So they were never in any kind of bookkeeping, financial role type situation. We have just a few, just over 10% as accountants. And over here, cashiers, personal bankers, we're looking like just under 10%. Again, the financial role, the ability, so we're not seeing a lot of that. So, how many years were in your previous position? See, we're at like, it's a lot. 10% or more, before becoming a bookkeeper, they were in other areas for a significant amount of time. What is your current Excel level? We have intermediate, a lot, like 57% say they have like intermediate level Excel. But when you're out hanging out with them and you are doing their budget logs, are you seeing that?
No. No, ma'am.
You're not seeing that?
No.
All right, so you'd say most of what you're seeing, they're all on beginner level? All right, so the beginner level right here is saying that it's only 17%, again, of 57 people that took the survey. All right, in what areas do you have experience? So we have some financial situation here, but accounts payable, now this is really weird because they don't work in accounts payable, but yet they have accounts payable and experience. They get the invoices and they send the invoices to account payable, but they don't process, you know, the invoices within accounts payable. We have payroll. Yes, they enter payroll for their staff that's on site. Journal transfers, I'm thinking they just key in the journal entries to get that done. Financial statements, okay. Financial statements is a big finance piece. I don't know about them doing financial statements, okay? And other. So,
do they have to rectify the P card for their
reconciliation? So maybe that could be considered that. Yeah, that's good point. Okay, what financial system have you used in the past? And as you can see, GUI is the main one that they use. Okay, so now, what support would you like your school, what support do you provide to your school on a daily basis? So, here are some things. Field trip, I'm not gonna read everything. They're field trip coordinator in their building, they do insurance, they are doing everything that the principal, of course, asked them to do.
Aaron's outside the
building. They are doing the security desk. So they're running the security desk sometimes.
Aaron's outside the building.
Aaron's outside the building. You know, we had a bookkeeper say she had to go to Home Depot to buy those pine straws to put down on the out in the yard for beautification. So see how that's taking away from them doing their bookkeeping functions. Here we go again. We see these are front office backup. They have to maintain the teacher's lounge. Of course, do filing. They have to do travel document, the compensation. You may be in the wrong room. Try the one next door. They're doing drills like fire drills, and cafeteria duty, bus duty. Let's see. All right, so those are some of the things that they are doing that would take them away from their duties. Yes, Sandra.
Could it be that because of how they're classified in the cab, they're not just classified as bookkeepers, it's secretary/bookkeeper?
Yes, and I think that's one of the main reasons, because they're like a catch-all, they do anything, all clerical duties, as well as bookkeeping duties.
But so, Sean, I thought that there was something sent out to the principals and administrators that said that they were only supposed to fall within this catchment. There was? Okay.
Yeah, but again, although it's sent out, you know, the principals, they
the pine
do that. Remember that line that Doc says, all the duties that are assigned? So, you know, if there's a spill, you need to, you know, go get it. And of course, we always say that's not fair because they're unable to get their real work done. Things that are very pertinent. So, what interpersonal skills do you possess? They can multitask. They're very sensitive. They're good listeners, etc. They have leadership capabilities. They have good communication skills, excellent customer service skills. Highly motivated self-starter with strong leadership. They're dependable, goal-oriented. How about different detailed communication skills, and they show empathy. Team player. List any prior training. So we know we have the bookkeeper's bootcamp. With finance, that's good, they do that. Then we have a tax preparer here that work with the IRS and H&R Block. Maybe there are some transferable skills there, you know. And the banking and finance is a good skill that's transferable. And training in all departments here, they have excellent PowerPoint training. Okay, what training should the district provide to better support you in your current position as a bookkeeper? Well, as you can see, the first one says they're burned out from all TCSD department training. But that one kind of like blew my mind. Said, you're not answering the question, okay? They need 100% support from the principals and APs, again. I can't help you with that one. I can't train you on that. Support bookkeepers with stipends to prevent monthly turnovers, overworked and underpaid. They can get the training on stipends, but I don't know about the rest. I think what they're saying is they want stipends. You know, almost every training we've had with them, except lately.